Okay, we're talking to Chris Sneddon, who top 10 finished final stage and has completed his first La Ruta. So overall, your impressions of La Ruta?
Toughest race I've ever done. I'd bet some of my teammates thousands of dollars that they could not win it. They think they're so great, but you know, this is a race that'll freaking make you hurt and make you want to quit a million times during each stage.
So are you glad you came?
Yeah. It's awesome. Like, rode railway ties for probably like 5 or 6K. You know, you freaking vibrate the crap out of yourself. It's not like say cobbles are tough. Well, try riding a railroad.
So you looked like you were having a little bit of trouble on that trestle bridge they had to cross.
Yeah, I was just a little sketched out. Had it almost wiped out on the little one before it. That was sort of like, wasn't very fun. But
so,
nothing major, just like a little slip. Oh shit, gotta go over, but I didn't go over.
So overall, pretty pleased with your results?
Yeah, no, I'll be back next year.
Good.
That was awesome.
Thanks a lot. Okay, we're talking with Andreas Hessler and Chris Sneddon, who just finished the final stage of La Ruta for 2007. So, congratulations, guys.
Thanks, Rob.
So, tell us a little bit about today's ride.
It was hard. You had to ride railway tracks for hours almost, maybe more like half an hour. It felt like a long time. You really wanted to quit when you were doing it. And then they had these crazy, sketchy railway bridges, which you almost fall off and die or something.
There's a 5 kilometer climb right out of the gun. So we tried to get with good groups, and then it rolled down this screaming 70k an hour descent. Rolled down to the coast for about 45 minutes of rolling, leg thrusting, riding. Got down to the coast, 45k. We're supposed to be 120 total. My kilometers at 130, notwithstanding the railroad ties, more railroad ties, and then water up to here on the beach for the last 20K. In and out of water, it was just gnarly.
So I hear you had some more flat problems.
Just one flat today.
Just one flat.
One yesterday, one today. Okay. Last year.
So it's getting a little better every year.
I think so.
So we asked you earlier after the first stage if you're coming back, and you said no. What about now?
Just ask me next year. It depends if I got good guys to ride with, then it's worth coming for. We had a great day riding together.
Good. Okay, so 2 top 10s, not so bad. It'll move you both up quite a bit. Overall, pretty pleased with your results overall?
Yeah, didn't think it was going to be this hard, but it's extremely hard. You train all year to try and win this, but you still probably wouldn't win it.
I think it's good to have brought Max and Chris down and expose them to this experience, and then they'll spread the word too. Even just as an off-season fun thing to do, you know, Carl Platt came without training, I've been without training. These guys have been training a bit more so they can enjoy it a bit. It's kind of crazy, weird riding, the roads are open, traffic's everywhere, cows, dogs, train tracks, railroads. It's fun, it's just an adventure.
Thanks a lot, guys. Now it's, I guess, time to go and have some beer and relax.
Beer? Oh, no, it's Gatorade and Power, protein, no beer.
Okay, we're talking with Corey Wallace, who had another excellent day in the final stage of La Ruta 2007. Not sure yet, but looks like probably top 15. So, how was it today?
Well, today it was felt good at the beginning, and about 50k in, I lost the main pack of 6 guys, and I spent the next 25k attempting to chase on. And at the second last checkpoint, I could just see him in the distance. Put my head down and caught him, but that basically emptied the tank. So then I kind of hung on to those guys the last maybe 15-20k and then biked in solo.
So overall, what do you think about La Ruta now you've done it?
I think it's awesome. There's so much to it. There's so many sections, like jungle section, in the ocean. It's just, you don't know what's coming up next.
So you'll be back?
I'd love to come back.
Okay. So what were your expectations coming down here? Were you looking for, because it looks like you'll probably have a top 15 overall in the GC.
Yeah, no, it's just coming down, not knowing what to expect. Just want to check it out and go someplace exotic. know, the snow and enjoy the sun.
Good. So now a little bit relaxing and have some food, and you're going to sit on the beach for a while?
Yeah, spend a few days on the beach and then, you know.
Thanks a lot.